Miami.
Anthem wraps up. We are just a minute away from kickoff as Fort Bend Christian Academy is about to come out of their tunnel, as Dallas Christian already has. Tonight, your Eagles are being coached by none other than head coach Jordan Black, who is an alum of Dallas Christian.
Dallas Christian Chargers face Fort Bend Christian
Head
Eagles.
Coach of...
Head coach Jordan Black. Head coach for the Chargers, Mike Wheeler.
Head coach for the Chargers is Mike Wheeler, who I believe the stadium is named after, Wheeler Stadium.
Tonight's officials are referee Brian Hughes.
We're out on a beautiful night here. Morris. The sun is just now
Ed
setting.
Cody Dixon.
It can't be more than 85 degrees. There's a nice breeze. It is a perfect night for football.
Going to be looking for a bright performance on both sides of the ball here for the Eagles tonight if they want to have a chance to beat a very talented Dallas Christian team. Jackson, what are we looking for offensively that we really need to stop this Chargers defense?
Offensively, they're going to need to come out throwing the ball. I think they're going to start out heavy run, but I believe that the key to success tonight is the Eagles throwing it deep on the Chargers defense and capitalizing off of Brian Domino and Braylon Gardone's speed. What about defense, Derek Jordan? We've seen a lot of issues on the defense last year when they played Dallas Christian. They got 35 points. What are they going to do this year to better help that situation?
Well, this year I think one of the biggest things that the Eagles need to do defensively is utilize Max Granville. He's going to be in the backfield on almost every play, offered from several schools in Texas throughout this week. He's going to be a critical part of the Eagles' defense in this game. But besides that, the Eagles have to cover the pass well. Cornerbacks Matthew Brown and Kobe Sellers have to have good games, with Spurs James Donovan and Jordan Rogers both need to play well tonight.
This way. Okay, I'm going to signal it in. Give me 1 second. Hey, men, shake them up. Have a good, clean matchup.
As the captains continue their shake, the Fort Bend Christian Academy Eagles won the toss and they'll defer to the second half. So the Charger offense, led by Luke Carney, will first take the field on this gorgeous Friday night.
Eagle kickoff looking to make a statement here. Really need a stop here on this first drive to set the tone early on. Eagles versus Chargers. Kickoff coming shortly.
You big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing, we will rock you. We will rock you.
Number 19, Emmanuel Montoya, is set to tee it off tonight for the Eagles. Back deep to receive it for the Chargers is number 2, Logan Walker, and number 3, Zach Hernandez.
One of the most anticipated matchups of the season, and we're underway.
Montoya boots it away deep. That one's going to be recovered by Hernandez right around the goal line. He'll take it out. He's going to get up past the 25-yard line, but only gained about 3 yards. So they'll set up shop around the 28-yard line as Luke Carney and the Charger offense sets up shop.
Here comes the Eagles defense. Need to set the tone here early on. We got number 55, Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth, and number 72, Jalen Zuber, both coming out on the line, along with Max Granville and Jacob Yorniod on the end. Looking to have a big start here in the from the line. Really got to win the battle in the trenches here.
Key player to watch, number 1 corner, Kobe Sellers, and he's absolutely electric. He had 2 return touchdowns last week, 1 punt and 1 kick return. So especially see him on defense. If he can get a pick 6, he's gone. Carney lines up in the shotgun. He'll hand it off to Hernandez on the first time, and he is stuffed and met at the line for a gain of none.
And I think something we really need to look at, Jax, is we know number 3, Will Nettles for Dallas Christian, is probably their most electric receiver on the offense, and he's lined up with number 1, Kobe Sellers, on a cornerback. That's very strategic from the Eagles.
That's going to be a matchup we're going to watch all night. We'll see how the Chargers handle it.
Two very fast, 2 very electric players.
It's 2nd and 10 now, still in shotgun with Hernandez to his right. He's going to drop back the pass and quickly look over to number 7. That's going to be complete for a gain of about 8 yards to number 7, Damian Christensen. And that's going to bring up 3rd and short now for the Chargers.
Good tackle there from number 9, Connor Tallis. Read that pass very well, just couldn't get to it in time. Going to be a reception gain of about 7, 8 yards on the play. 3rd down and short for the Chargers.
Linebacking core for the Eagles brought to you by George Ranch. Caleb Bratcher and Connor Tallis both come away of George Ranch High School out in Richmond, Texas. And it's now 3rd and 1 to go here. He fakes the handoff, and he's going to break up the middle. He's going to have a huge gain down the sideline. And he's going to be wrapped up and tackled around the 15-yard line by Ben Longwood, but not for a huge run. What a play.
Great read option there from 9, Luke Carney. Had the jet sweep in motion from number 3, Will Nettles. Really got the Eagles' defense off guard. The Eagles have been watching film all week, and they've seen how critical of a player Will Nettles has been for this Charger offense. Completely caught him off guard, and that's going to be a gain of about 60 yards for the Chargers.
Chargers now have the ball on the Eagle 14-yard line. They're in the red zone. Carney lines up in shotgun. He motions the tight end over to his left. He'll give the handoff to Hernandez. He'll bust it up the middle, up and near to the 3-yard line. And that's going to be good for a first down instead of a first and goal opportunity for the Chargers.
First breakaway run there for Hernandez. That's going to be good for about 10 yards. Eagles really need to make an adjustment here if they want to stop a touchdown and keep the Chargers off the board.
Hernandez, a transfer from Rockwall, Texas, not far outside of Dallas. A big pickup for Dallas Christian this year as he's an elusive back there from Rockwall.
Rockwall, another very good team here in Texas. He's going to be a big piece of this Dallas Christian offense tonight.
The Chargers line up in I formation with one receiver to the top. And they're going to run a toss sweep here. And they're going to get into the end zone for a touchdown.
Great play there from Dallas Christian right there. Little pitch from Carney to Hernandez, and Carney became the lead blocker there. Created a nice hole for Hernandez, and Hernandez is going to punch it in for 6. Not the start the Eagles were looking for defensively. Had a few good stops in those first few plays, and then that one read ops where Carney broke down the field for about 60 yards really caught him off guard.
Number 44, Jack Lowry, on to kick the extra point. It's up, and it is good. 7-0 is your score now as the Dallas Christian Chargers jump out to an early lead on their first possession over the Eagles with 9:25 remaining in the first quarter. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV. We'll be right back. Dallas Christian kick coverage takes the field now as the Eagles are set to receive the ball. Back deep for the Eagles, number 1, Kobe Sellers, and number 7, Braylon Gardoni. Eagles need to recover from their first drive as the defense could not stop the Chargers. The offense looking to throw counterpunch here.
We'll see how the Eagles can respond here. Looking to put 7 on the board after a strong start from the Dallas Christian offense. Putting a touchdown on the board within the first 2 minutes of play. We'll see how the Eagles respond here.
The kick is up, and it is going to be to Braylon Gardoni. And it is going to die around the 20-yard line and not get out of bounds. But number 21, Jordan Rodgers, is going to jump on that ball before Dallas Christian can recover it. And that'll be honestly a perfect kick for the Chargers that was almost recovered.
Very risky play from Braylon Gardone to let that ball drop right there. I think he thought it might hit the ground and roll out of bounds. And if so, that would have been a smart play from Gardone. But that ball had some good spin on it. It just died right after it hit the ground.
Stands in now the senior quarterback committed to Brown, Brady Dever. He's in his third year under Coach Carpen at Fort Bend Christian Academy. So he's very well versed in the offense, looking to have a huge senior year and lead the Eagles to a state championship. First play is out of pistol. He'll hand it off to Ethan Williams, and he's going to be met behind the line, and that's going to be a loss of about a yard.
Great tackle right there from Dallas Christian number one, Chris Scott. The junior making a good play right there. We'll see how the Eagles can respond. Looking to get something going here on offense. Williams with a loss of one on the play. It's going to be second and 11 here for the Eagles.
Dever now in shotgun with Donovan lined in as an inline tight end. He drops back to pass. He's going to step up in the pocket. He's going to look deep for Tyler Curry. And that's going to be overthrown, and that's going to be incomplete. And that's going to bring up third and 11 now for the Eagles.
Great throw there from Brady Dever. Already seeing him throw the ball deep. Tyler Curry there just ran inside a little bit. If he had stayed on the outside, that would have been a great ball from Dever and probably a touchdown for the Eagles. Tyler Curry, just a sophomore on this team, taking over as a starting role for Marcus Cretion last year.
Third and long now for the Eagles. They line up in the same formation with Donovan as an inline tight end and in the shotgun. Dever takes a high snap. He'll fake the handoff. He's going to be instantly pressured in the back of him, brought down for a sack. And that's going to be a huge three and out for the Chargers.
Yeah, a lot of defensive pressure on the line from the Chargers. They're clearly winning the battle in the trenches right now as the offensive line of the Eagles just folded under pressure right there, and Dever had nowhere to go, nowhere to escape. Quick three and out for the Eagles. It'll be fourth down and very long, and the punt team comes out.
Chargers have two players back deep to receive this punt. The Eagles will be punting from their own end zone here. Montoya receives the low snap, and he sends it away. And it's going to be fair caught right around the 44-yard line. And that's where the Chargers will set up shop on offense inside of the Eagle territory already. Great field position. We'll see if the Eagles can get a stop here. We'll be back after a short break. Chargers are back on offense. Sophomore Luke Carney in an empty set here. Three receivers down low, two up top. It is first and 10. He drops back and throws a quick bubble screen to the outside. It's going to be instantly blown up by Matthew Brown for a loss of four. And that's going to bring up second and 14.
Great play from Matthew Brown. He had a great game last week. A lot of those big plays coming from number 25. He hits hard. He had a great offseason, got a lot stronger, a lot faster. He's working well at that cornerback spot this year. He's going to be a big part of this Eagle defense.
Second and 15 now for the Chargers. On the Eagle 48-yard line, Hernandez is back in the backfield. Three receivers down low, one up top, as Hernandez is switching sides. And that ball's going to be handed off to Hernandez and instantly hit at the midfield. And he's going to lose another 2 yards, and that's going to bring up third and 17.
Great start on this drive for the Eagle defense. A lot of great work from Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth and Jalen Zuber to get that tackle right there. On that last play, Max Granville with the pressure on Luke Carney. He almost tipped that ball in the air. Low pass from Carney. Allow Matthew Brown to make that tackle. Great start here. Eagle defense playing a lot better as a team on this drive.
Third and what seems to be forever now for the Chargers. We'll see if they go to the air here or keep it on the ground. Chargers are bunched in tight, but they're gonna throw it. Carney rolls out to his right. He's gonna evade one pressure, and he's not gonna get evade the second. As Ivan Jimmy Duxworth is gonna bring him down for a loss of 10. What a huge sack for the Eagles, and that's gonna bring up fourth down.
Incredible pressure there from Max Granville and Ivan Jimmy Duxworth. Granville got to Carney early on. Him and Jacob Yorniel switched sides of the ball just before the snap, and the pressure was there from the very beginning. Fourth down and 27 to go for the Chargers.
The Chargers on fourth and 27. Luke Carney looks like he's going to be into squid punt it. And it's going to be recovered after a short punt by Sellers, but there's a flag on the play as one of the Eagle defenders ran into the punter. And we'll see what the call is.
I believe we're going to get a roughing the kicker penalty here on the Eagles. And that might be a free first down for the Chargers.
And what a huge blow to the Eagle momentum, as the personal foul will bring up an automatic first down for the Chargers.
Smart play there from Carney to wait till that Eagle defense got to him. He saw the pressure coming and waited just a little bit. Clear personal foul there from the Eagles. After three humongous plays from the Eagle defense, the Chargers have a free first down around the 50-yard line. Crushing blow to this Eagle momentum.
5:38 here left to go in the first quarter. 7-0 is your score. The Dallas Christian Chargers lead the Fort Bend Christian Academy Eagles. We have a beautiful night here in Mesquite, Texas. First and 10 now. Carney hands it off to Hernandez. He's going to get up to about midfield for a gain of about 3 as a flag flies in.
Gain of about 3 yards, but there's a penalty marker on the play.
I believe that ball is going to be coming back. A great run from Hernandez there. We'll see what the call is from the ref here. We got a personal foul on the defense. And instead of coming back, that's going to move about 15 yards more from the last line of scrimmage. Eagles really giving the Chargers their own momentum here. We had 4th and 27. And now the Chargers have a first down in Eagle territory.
The Chargers have gotten all of those yards back here just off of 2 Eagle penalties. A crushing blow here and a devastating loss for the Eagles. They would have had the ball back here in great field position. But now the Chargers are threatening in Eagle territory. It's first down. Carney drops back to pass. It's going to be brought down again by Ivan Jimmy Duxworth for his second sack of the night. What a play by the junior.
Jimmy Duxworth breaking through that offensive line. He's shooting that A-gap, currently playing at that nose tackle position. Jimmy Duxworth having a great game so far. That's going to be a loss of about 10 yards for the Chargers. His second sack of the night. And we'll see how the Eagles continue to respond here. A lot of momentum going the Chargers' way, but Jimmy Duxworth might have saved it there.
Back on the Eagles' 45-yard line. It's 2nd and 20 here. Hernandez gets motioned out. Carney will fake the throw, and he's going to do a QB draw up the middle. And he's going to be tackled by Jordan Rogers. And that took it up to about the 38-yard line. And that's going to leave about 3rd and 7 to go.
Huge hit there from number 21, Jordan Rogers. But nonetheless, number 9, Luke Carney with a great fake right there. QB draw that gained back about 12 yards for Carney. 3rd down and 8 to go from the Eagles' 34-yard line.
Big 3rd down here for both sides. Carney still in shotgun for the Chargers. Trips low and one receiver up top. One receiver motions in. And it's going to be a quarterback keeper. And Carney's going to get up for the first down. And there's going to be a flag on the play.
That's enough for a Charger first down, but there's a penalty marker down.
Flag in the backfield. We'll see who this is on. That QB draw not working well against the Eagle defense tonight. And I believe the penalty is going to be on the Chargers. And Luke Carney's First down will be coming back.
Holding offense, number 78. 10 yards from the spot of the help. Replay third down.
Third down's going to go again as there was holding on the offensive line. Big play there, and that's going to set up third and about 18 to go here. Brutal loss here for the Chargers, but they've picked up this before.
Third and eight turns to third and 18. But you got to remember the Chargers did convert a fourth and 27 on a penalty against the Eagles. We'll see how the defense responds here.
Carney rolls out to his right. He's looking deep. He's going to throw, and that's going to be way behind the intended receiver, number four, Austin Ellis. And that's going to bring up fourth and 18.
Surely the Chargers will choose to punt again here. Punting from about the 43-yard line. And Eagle territory, however.
Kobe Sellers is back deep to receive the punt for the Eagles. I imagine we'll see the Eagles be a lot more cautious here on their pursuit of the punter.
Definitely don't want another personal foul roughing the kicker penalty that gives the Chargers an automatic first down. That's going to be a horrible snap. 21 Rogers in the backfield, and he tackles Carney, who recovers the ball at the Chargers' 30-yard line, and the Eagles will set up shop deep in Charger territory.
Big-time play there for the Eagles. Just a momentum swing they may need as they have the ball inside of Charger territory on the 31.
And Brady Dever in the offense with no production on the last drive. They'll look to score here. Great field position for the Eagles at the 31-yard line in Charger territory. We'll see what the Eagles choose to do. Not a lot of production from the run or pass game.
One thing to take note of, when we were down in the field, we noticed that the upright the Eagles are approaching right now is very crooked, so kicking a field goal is going to be definitely interesting to this side of the field. Don't know if it'll play a factor tonight, but this upright is definitely crooked. Brady Dever in the pistol. He's going to toss it back to Kobe Sellers out of the backfield. He's going to have blockers in front of him, and he's going to race to the sideline. He's going to get down to about the 7-yard line after a huge run.
Great run there from Kobe Sellers, and that's something we haven't seen this year is Kobe Sellers in the backfield. That may have been something they installed this week at practice, but Kobe Sellers with a lot of speed coming out of the backfield, he's going to be dangerous.
First and goal now for the Eagles. Domino is low. As Donovan's lineup is an inline blocker, and so is Max Granville. Dever in the shotgun. That snap is high. As Dever rolls out, he's just going to throw that one away before getting sacked. And that's going to bring up second and six.
A lot of pressure there from the defensive line. Dever did have to escape to avoid the sack. Dever with a smart decision to throw that ball away, avoid any loss of yards. Ball on the 6-yard line. We got second and goal coming up here for the Eagles. Eagles looking to respond from an early touchdown within the 9-minute mark from the Chargers.
Eagles bring it back to the line in the pistol. Ethan Williams is the back. Donovan and Granville are in as tight ends. Domino and Gardoni are receivers. Dever hands it off to Williams, and he's going to get blasted in the backfield. And he's going to get maybe back to the line of scrimmage. And that's going to bring up third and goal.
And the Chargers looking strong in that defensive front. Eagle offensive line having a hard time stopping that. They're bringing a lot of pressure to the backfield, both on Dever and Williams so far this game. We'll see how the Eagles respond if they choose to go to the air here. Only offensive play, really, with true production has been from Kobe Sellers. Kobe Sellers currently not on the field, so we'll see what the Eagles look to.
Eagles staying in the same formation in the pistol. Third and goal here. Dever fakes the handoff, and he looks for Gardner to the back of the end zone. He's going to run it himself, and he's going to get in for a touchdown.
Great run there from Brady Dever, running with intensity there from about the 10-yard line. Had the fake pitch, and Brady Dever saw a hole, and he hit it hard. Brady Dever with a touchdown. That's his third rushing touchdown on the year in two games. 6-7, Eagles with a huge comeback.
2:07 here left in the first quarter, and we've got ourselves a ball game, folks.
Montoya on for the extra point. He's been pretty accurate this year. One missed, which was blocked in the last game.
James Donovan in on the hold. Montoya's kick is up, and it is good. 7-7 is now your score here in Mesquite. Chargers and Eagles all tied up. We'll be back after a short break.
Dallas Christian Fine Arts Department is selling nothing but cake buntinis near the front gate. You may purchase buntinis, one for $3 or 12 for $30 while supplies last.
Back here in the action, the first quarter. Eagles and Chargers are tied up at 7. 2:07 left here in the first quarter. On a beautiful night here, with a nice breeze, very pleasant temperatures. It can't get much better weather for a football game. Montoya in the kicker for the Eagles, and he sends it away deep. And that one's going to be taken by Hernandez at the goal line. He's going to look upfield. There's going to be a flag in on the play, as Hernandez is going to get it, take out this one all the way up to about the 32-yard line.
Definitely a block in the back there from the Chargers. That's going to come back a little bit. Great return there from Hernandez, however, getting the ball to about the 32-yard line.
And I believe the official is pointing at the 23-yard line, and a block in the back is usually half. Is usually half the distance to the goal. So that should back them up deep into their own territory.
Very positive break here for the Eagle kickoff team.
Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 13-yard line.
Chargers take over at the 13-yard line in their own territory. We'll see what Luke Kearney comes out with. Eagle defense still looking strong. We see Chiso Ajoku comes in for Jalen Zuber. Number 55, Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth, and Max Granville still on the field for the Eagles.
First and 10 now here on the 13. Kearney's in shotgun with a bunch set and one receiver up, the two receivers up top. Kearney takes a snap and he'll hand it off to Hernandez, and that's going to get just about to the line of scrimmage. But not much further.
Great tackle there from Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth. He's been a critical player for this Eagle defense tonight, already with two sacks in the first quarter and several tackles on number two Hernandez to add on to it. Going to be second down and 10 for the Chargers after the no game. Number nine, Kearney, jogs back to the huddle. We'll see what the Chargers look to change here.
Second and 10 now. Three receivers down low. Kearney in shotgun. He looks low. He pumps, and he's going to be taken down by Granville for a huge sack down to the 5-yard line, and that's going to bring up third and 18.
And that's a third sack here from the Eagles defense. Max Granville and Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth have been all over the place, really attacking the right side of that Charger offensive line. They've been in the backfield on almost every play. Great play there from the Eagles and Max Granville to give the Eagles some momentum. Third and 17 to go. We'll see what the Chargers come back with.
This is where the Chargers have been so dangerous. Either picking up penalties or finding a way to get a first down. We'll see if they can pick it up, or if the Eagles can make a stand. It's third and 17. Kearney, as the play clock was winding down, the Chargers would like to take a timeout to avoid the delay of game.
Timeout on the field.
As the Chargers take a timeout, we'll take a short timeout with them. We'll be right back.
Timeout, Dallas Christian. Don't forget to stop in to the Big Blue 2 store to purchase your DC Spirit Wear. The store is located by the Charger Grill and is open until the end of the third quarter. Go Big Blue. Go Chargers. If the Chargers win tonight, so do our Charger fans. To celebrate a home game victory, we all win one of the following Wednesday with 15% off one item in DC school store, the Big Blue. Don't forget to mention your winning Wednesday discount when you shop at the Big Blue on Wednesday following a Chargers varsity football team home game.
High school football came back last week. College football comes in full-fledged this week, and the NFL comes back on Thursday. It doesn't get much better than this to see football coming back. It's now 3rd and 17 here from the Chargers' 6-yard line as Luke Kearney's in shotgun. Kearney fakes the handoff. It's going to be another QB draw, and he's going to be tripped up by James Donovan right around the line of scrimmage. And that's going to bring up fourth down.
Great read from number 6 for the Eagles. If Kearney had broken around Donovan, he was probably past that first down marker. Great save there from number 6, James Donovan. And as the clock winds down, that'll take us to the end of the first quarter. Score is Chargers 7, Eagles 7. Great first quarter of football. We'll be right back.
Chargers 7, Eagles 7.
We're back here in the second quarter as we flip sides of the field. Luke Kearney is in to punt for the Chargers. Kobe Sellers is back deep to receive. Kearney skies that one high, but it's not going to get far. That one's going to take a nice eagle bounce. That one's only going to get to the 25-yard line as the Eagles set up a beautiful field position on this next drive.
And I almost want to say that number 6, James Donovan, did get a finger or two on that ball. That ball did not go very far. Punting from the end zone. Kearney only got that ball to about the 30-yard line before it rolled back to about the Charger 20. Eagles will set up shop at about the 24-yard line. We'll see what Dever and the offense can do here.
Eagles going 4 wide here with Ethan Williams in as the back in the pistol formation. Dever hands it off to Williams up to the right side. He's going to get leveled right at the line of scrimmage for a gain of about 1, maybe.
Williams' helmet coming off on the play. He was crushed, and not a whole lot of production here on the run so far from the Eagles. Eagles looking to a bit of trickery, some pass plays, and some read option from Dever, mostly for yardage here on offense. We'll see what the Eagles can do. Two backs, Sorrell Taylor and Ethan Williams. Haven't seen Taylor tonight. Also haven't seen TJ Smith tonight, who came in late in the previous game. It's been all Ethan Williams here so far against the Chargers. 2nd and 10, let's see what the Eagles can do.
TJ Smith appears to be in here as a wide receiver. We saw him a lot at running back. He's going to be in for James Donovan after his last defensive effort. 2nd and 10 here, and Dever from the shotgun. Ethan Williams still the back. Dever fakes the handoff. He's going to look to the right side of Gardoni. That one's going to be overthrown and incomplete. That's going to bring up third and 10.
Brandon Gardoni with a great route there. Had TJ Smith on the same route on the other side. TJ Smith almost had a break on that cornerback. Almost could have looked to the left side of the field and had a touchdown to Smith there. But obviously Dever was looking to Gardoni as his first option. I believe that's how that play is drawn up, is to go to Dever there.
Third and 10 now here. 11-12 left in the second quarter as the officials change balls here. As the play clock is running down to about 3-2 as the official accounts are resetting the play clock. Dever gets a toss sweep to Williams on third and 10, and he's going to be tripped up behind the line. And he's maybe going to gain 1 yard there. And that's going to bring up fourth and 9.
Eagle field goal unit will come out. Strong kicker, number 19, Emmanuel Montoya. He's been a reliable kicker for the Eagles. We'll see if he can come up with the clutch here and give the Eagles the lead in this second quarter.
This is certainly in Montoya's range, as last week he hit a 44-yarder. So kicking from 40 yards here should be no big deal.
A star on the soccer team. He's certainly got a big leg. We'll see if he can split the uprights here.
Montoya's kick is up. And it's going to be wide right and no good. And that's going to be a failed possession for the Eagles and a big stop for the Chargers.
And Montoya's kick definitely had the distance just a little wide right. Chargers get off the field with no harm done from the Eagle offense.
Eagle defense trots back out, looking to pick up another stop. Luke Carney in the offense, looking to set up shop now on the 23-yard line, looking to go 77 yards here to try and take a lead back.
And obviously, Jackson, if the Chargers want to have any production on offense, they're going to have to figure out a way to stop number 55 and number 13 from the Eagle front. Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth and Max Granville have been all over the place, as we talked about earlier on in this game. Even on the left side of the line, getting in the backfield, Chiso Ajoku and Jacob Yarnyeld. And on this drive, we'll see Jackson praying in on the action here for the Eagles. We'll see what they can do.
First and 10 now for the Chargers on the 23-yard line. Carney's in shotgun. Three receivers beneath him as Carney checks the play to the sideline. He's going to check out of the original play. 10 seconds left on the play clock. Carney takes a snap. It's going to be a read option to the right, and he's going to keep it. And that's going to be a gain of about
around the right side, brought down by
maybe a yard.
Tripped up by number 32, Jacob Yarnyeld on the play. The junior winning the starting job this year at that left end position, playing alongside Max Granville here at the end. Carney attacking the right side there. That's not something they've done much tonight. Obviously, the stronger side of the line being on the left with Jimmy Ducksworth and Granville. We'll see if the Chargers continue to push to the right side or if they open up to the left.
Second down and 9 here for the Chargers as Carney's in shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Hernandez, and Hernandez is going to get downhill fast. And he's going to be tackled around the 32-yard line, just about a yard shy of the first down.
Great run there from Hernandez. That's been his first run for several yards in quite a while. Hernandez picking up a gain of about 8 yards on the play.
Brings up third down and 1.
Third and 1 here for the Chargers as Carney's going to go under center, and they're going to go for a QB sneak, but they were not set, it appears.
Penalty marker on the play.
There's a flag down, and it was immediately blown dead.
And the QB sneak will be rendered ineffective as the false start backs them up 5 yards. It'll be a much less manageable 3rd and 6 now here for the Chargers. We'll see if they can convert from the 27-yard line.
3rd and 6 from the 27 here with 9:14 to go in the quarter.
Number 1, Chris Scott jogs onto the field. He'll set up in the backfield along with Hernandez.
The Eagles are going to appear to have jumped offsides into the neutral zone. We'll see what the call is. And they're going to call a false start on the offense.
And what was third down and one to go turns into third down and 11 to go off of two false start penalties from the Chargers offensive line.
The rule states that if a defensive player jumps in the neutral zone and an offensive player does not react, it's not offsides. But if a defensive player jumps in the neutral zone and an offensive player reacts, that should be neutral zone infraction. But defensive player jumped in and the offensive player reacted way too late, and that's why there was a false start. Carney in shotgun. He's looking for the screens. Scott, that's going to be complete. But he's maybe going to get back to the original line of scrimmage, but there is a flag on the field.
Eagle defense praying that that flag marker goes against the Chargers. Number 6, James Donovan on the tackle. And it appears that Matthew Brown is going to be walking off the field a little bit slow.
Downfield. Okay, the ball was caught at the neutral zone. The play fouls, fourth down.
The official picks up the flag as the ball was caught behind the line of scrimmage, so no ineligible man downfield. But that's going to bring up fourth down and about 7.
Very big stop there for the Eagles. Turn a third down and 1 into fourth down and 7. Chargers hurting themselves a little bit, but nonetheless, the Eagles will take it. Kobe Sellers back to receive the punt from Carney.
A big field position battle taking place here as Carney in to punt it. As he gets to be in probably one of his better punts of the night. And he's going to take the Eagles off a nice bounce all the way down to the Eagle 28-yard line.
Great punt there from Carney. Definitely better than his previous punt that went about 20 yards. Eagles offense will take over at their own 28-yard line. We'll be right back.
Back here in the second quarter, 8:20 left to go. 7-7 is the score as the Eagle offense takes the field with Brady Dever in shotgun again. Two receivers down low, one up top, one tight end. Dever's going to hand it off to Ethan Williams as he's going to gain about 1, but a flag is going to be down in on the play right around the line of scrimmage.
We're going to have a holding call against the offense. That'll back the Eagles up to about their own 17-yard line.
That's going to be a holding call on junior Bennett Warren, 6'8", 300-pound lineman for the Eagles.
Warren collecting a few of his own offers this week from some schools in Texas as he looks to play D1 collegiate football. Number 76 with a holding penalty that will back the Eagle offense up just a little bit.
First and 20 now for the Eagles. Way deep in their own territory on the 17. Eagles line up in the pistol with Williams as the back. Williams breaks up field. And he's going to get right back around the original line of scrimmage for a gain of 10.
Great run there from Ethan Williams. His first run for a really positive yardage. He'll gain about 10 on the play, putting the Eagles back the original line of scrimmage. We'll see what the Eagles look to do to continue to move the ball upfield, get some points on the board, take the lead against the Chargers.
7:35 left here in the second quarter. Devers now in shotgun. Two receivers up top, two down low. He drops back to pass, and he looks over to Brian Dom. That's going to be hauled in for a catch around the 40-yard line. That's going to be a first down for the Eagles.
Great play there from Brian Domino, and that's his first target of the game. Brian Domino with a great catch there for about 15 yards on the play. That'll move the chains.
That'll be the Eagles' first completed pass of the night. That brings up first down.
Dever with targets to Curry and to Gardoni on the night, but his first to Brian Domino, and that'll be complete for the Eagles.
First and 10 from the 40. High snap as Dever hands it off to Williams. Williams breaks one tackle as he shakes down for a gain of about 3 yards to the 43.
Ethan Williams, once he has handed off the ball, is instantly met with pressure from Dallas Christian's defense. Not a lot of production here on the run for the Eagles so far this game. Mostly coming from those big plays. Kobe Sellers' jet sweep to the other side of the field, as well as Dever's throw to Brian Domino. And then every now and then we'll see Dever take the ball himself. 6:45 on the clock. 7-7 is your score. Eagles look to produce.
Dever in shotgun here. Two receivers up top. Dever fakes the handoff. He steps up in the pocket, evading the pressure. He's going to get sacked in the backfield. And there's going to be a flag on the play. That's likely a hold.
There's a penalty marker on the play.
We'll see what the ref motions, and it will be a hold against the Eagles. They'll back him up about 10 yards to their own 33-yard line. Looking at about 2nd and 17 here for the Eagles.
Another holding call on right tackle Bennett Warren, the junior, as he backs up the Eagles another 10 yards.
Warren needing to make an adjustment here on this drive as he's cost the Eagles 20 yards so far. Second and 17, the Eagles look to respond once again after the loss of yards.
Second and 17 now on the 32. The Eagles back in shotgun here. Two receivers up top, two down low. Dever looking for Williams out the backfield. He's wide open. He's going to get a first down and more as he's going to get up past midfield to about the 53-yard line. A huge gain of about 20 yards for the Eagles.
Pursuit from number 6, Maddox Loescher from Dallas Christian. But once again, Ethan Williams with a great route. Completely had the Charger defense off guard. That'll be good for at least 20 yards on the play. First down here for the Eagles.
Dever in shotgun here. On the 46, Dever hands it off. He's going to keep it on the zone read. And he's going to make a play and get all the way down to about the 26-yard line before being tackled. That's going to be another first down.
And that's good for Dever's second big run of the game. The first one being for the Eagles. Only touchdown so far this game. The Eagles really starting to produce on the ground here in this offensive drive. We'll see what they can do in the next 5 minutes of this half.
Eagles starting to move the ball now with some tempo. Dever in shotgun. Three receivers up top. Gardoni by himself down low pressed. Dever pitches it on the zone read to Williams. Williams going to get down to about the 20-yard line before being pushed out of bounds. That's going to be about a 5-yard gain. That's going to bring up 2nd and 5.
Great play there from Ethan Williams. Running a lot of that pitch to Williams so far this game. The read option there. Dever has proved that he can use his feet this season as he had about a 72-yard run on that last game last week. Already proving he can do it with his feet this week too. It was not just a one-game thing. Dever working on the athleticism. He's been a big part of his Eagle production tonight.
Eagle offensive line starting to take shape on this drive. 2nd and 4 now. Dever drops back. He's looking for Donovan in the corner of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete.
Just out of the hands of number 6, James Donovan there. He's been playing both ways this year, playing on defense as that spur hybrid safety linebacker position, and on offense. He's resumed his role as a wide receiver. That ball was on a dot to James Donovan. Unfortunately, could not bring it in for the touchdown. Third down and short here for the Eagles. We'll see what they can do.
James Donovan had a great game tonight so far. And now that brings up 3rd and 4 for the Eagle offense from the Charger 19-yard line. Dever in shotgun yet again. As he's going to hand it off to Williams, and Williams is going to be hit in the backfield and taken down for a loss of about 5 yards, and that's going to bring up 4th down.
Great play there from number 1, Chris Scott, in the backfield to get Williams, and we'll see if the field goal unit comes back on. Montoya already with a missed field goal tonight.
Eagle offense appearing to stay on the field here on 4th and 9. With 4:45 left to go in the second, the Eagles trusting their offense here to score or pick up the first down. Big turning point in the game right here.
9 yards here for the Eagles for the first down. 24 to the end zone.
Dever in shotgun. He looks to his left. And he finds Gardoni wide open over the middle. And he's going to be tackled right around the 2-yard line. What a great route and an even better throw by Brady Dever.
Excellent decision from Coach Aaron Carpenter to go for it there on 4th down and 9. Eagles going to take the ball at about the 1 or 2 yard line.
Eagles playing with tempo here as they line up quickly to the line of scrimmage. Dever in shotgun. He hands it off to Williams as Williams is going to dive into the end zone for a touchdown.
Great drive there from the Eagles to get the touchdown to put another 6 on the board. Brady Dever and Braylon Gardoni connecting on the 23-yard pass there to set up the Eagle touchdown. Ethan Williams punches it in. Great drive there from the Eagles.
4:08 left here in the second quarter as the Eagles take a 13-7 lead, looking to make it 14-7 now with Emmanuel Montoya's extra point. James Donovan, the ever-reliable holder. Caleb Bratcher, number 8, in on the snap. Donovan gets the hold down. Montoya's kick is up, and it is good. 14-7 is now your score with 4:08 left in the second. Fort Bend Christian leads the Chargers. We'll be back after a short break. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV. Eagles leads 14-7 over the Dallas Christian Chargers in Dallas. As the sun has set over a nice night, as Montoya boots it away. Hernandez will field it around the 3-yard line. He'll return it. He's going to get a nice return up to about the 30-yard line before a tackle is made by number 11.
Keen himself getting in on the action tonight. Brother Cliff Self graduated last year. He was the starting center for the Eagles. He's off at Auburn University right now. Number 11, Keenum, looking to fill the shoes of Cliff. Cliff was a lineman. Keenum playing the role of linebacker here. He plays on the kickoff team as well for the Eagles. Injury timeout on the field. We'll take a short break as the Eagles defense prepares to take on Luke Kearney and the offense of the Chargers. We'll be right back.
Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
First and 10 here on the Fort Bend 30-yard line. Chargers and looking to go 70 yards here to tie this game back up as they're down by 7. Luke Kearney looking for an answer here. Chris Scott in the backfield as he looks over to the sideline to check out of the play. Kearney in shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Scott. Scott's going to break it up for a nice run. And he's going to be tackled around the 44-yard line. And that's going to be a big first down for the Chargers.
Jacob Bjorniel couldn't get off the block to get to Chris Scott. just couldn't make that tackle there. Chris Scott's going to break up field for a gain of about 20 yards. Great start for the Chargers here on this offensive drive. 3.5 minutes left. The Chargers look to respond to the Eagle touchdown.
Luke Kearney in shotgun yet again. He hands it out to Scott. The Eagles are ready that time. Bjorn Yell in on the tackle. That's going to be a no gain.
Clear adjustment was made there from the Eagle front. Bjorn Yell and Chiso Ajoku in on the tackle. Chris Scott goes nowhere as Hernandez will come into the game for number one. The clock is slowly winding down. 3 minutes left on the clock. The Eagle defense really needs to make a stop here going into the halftime with some confidence. In case you missed it, the Eagles did win the toss and deferred to the second half. So the Eagles will get the ball in the third quarter.
Second and 10 here with just under 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. Kearney in shotgun. He's going to hand it off to Hernandez. As Hernandez is only going to get a gain of about 2 yards. And that's going to bring up third and 8.
Had to rush there a little bit from the Charger offense. Play clock was winding down very quickly. Line rush to the line of scrimmage. Skill players got set for a short gain of 2.
After the first drive, the Charger offense has not amassed much else as they drove methodically down the field. But ever since then, the Eagles have had an answer. It's third and 8 here. The Chargers are looking to counterpunch and replicate what they had in the first drive. Kearney fakes the handoff, and he's going to be tackled by Self right around the 45-yard line. And that's going to be fourth and 4 now on the 45.
Great read from Jacob Bjornjeld as he absolutely expected Kearney to keep that ball. Didn't even bite for the jet sweep from Will Nettles. Number 9 was taken down very fast. Fourth down and short for the Chargers. We'll see if they opt to go for it.
1:40 left on the clock here. So they're playing a time game here, trying to maybe convert, but not give the Eagles much time if they don't convert. There's going to be official timeout on the field.
Official timeout on the field.
Stay on the field. We're just getting the player out real quick.
Officials will stop the game to make a short substitution here. 1:30 on the clock.
Fourth and 4 now here to go. Hernandez and Kearney in the backfield as they're looking to go for it. Kearney's also the punter, so they may do a pooch kick here. As the Eagles will call timeout with 1:30 to go to reassess their defense. We'll be back after a short break. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV.
Eagles.
Charge in the first half. First charge.
Now, Kearney and the Charger offense are going for it. We'll see if they just look to draw the Eagles offside on a hard count. That's what it looks like so far. Eagles not showing any signs of jumping as Dallas Christian will call a timeout. As the Eagles stay disciplined on defense and don't fall in for the trap.
Chargers really just ran back on the field to try to get the Eagles to jump off sides and get a free first down. We'll see what they come back with after the timeout. We'll be back after a short break.
We want to welcome all the fans that traveled from Sugar Land, from Fort Bend. We're glad you guys are here tonight. Fourth and four for the Chargers.
Fourth and four here for the Chargers as Luke Kearney is back deep to punt. It's going to be a high snap. That one's barely going to get over the heads of the players. That one's going to dribble down to about the 20-yard line as the Eagles will set up shop looking to go 80 yards to score a touchdown. Coming up soon this winter, we have winter sports, basketball, girls basketball. Make sure to tune in back in the winter to watch star players Jaden Ariza, Eduardo Vidal, take the Eagle offense along with women's basketball, Evan Carpenter and Gracie Peschel. Make sure to tune in the winter and also tune in to soccer. We'll be broadcasting boys and girls soccer. Make sure to tune in. Stay here on FBCA TV. We'll bring you all the sports. 1:18 to go here. Eagles looking to go 80 yards. Devereaux and shotgun. A quick out to Domino is going to be caught at the 28-yard line. That's going to be a gain of about 8 yards.
That was number two, Brian Domino, on the reception. Quick out route, getting out of bounds to stop the clock. Figured maybe the Eagles would come out here and just try to run the clock down, but it appears the Eagles are trying to score and extend this lead just before halftime.
Second and two on the 28. 1:12 to go here. Devereaux shotgun. Brady looking deep to James Donovan. That one's going to fall incomplete, just overthrown and out past the hands of Donovan. That's going to bring up third and two with 1:04 to go.
Two targets to James Donovan tonight brings two incompletions for Brady Devereaux. Two slight overthrows. Both would have been big gains if they were completed. Eagles looking to convert on third down here. Get the clock going, at least going to halftime with a 7-point lead.
Third and two here, Devereaux shotgun. Devereaux steps up in the pocket, having no one open downfield. And that's going to be incomplete as Domino stepped out of bounds when he caught the ball.
Domino out of bounds is the call on the field, incomplete.
And they're saying Brian Domino stepped out of bounds before coming back into play to make the catch. It's going to be fourth down and two to go. We'll see if the Eagles look to convert on fourth down and keep this drive alive with 58 seconds left in the game. And it appears Coach Carp will keep the offense on the field. A lot of confidence in Brady Devereaux and the Eagle offense to convert on fourth down here.
Just 58 seconds left in the half. Devereaux shotgun. As the Chargers appear to have jumped off sides. As we're waiting a call from the officials. As a timeout has been called. Before the delay of game, the Eagles called a timeout.
No delay of game on the play.
58 seconds, that's the Eagles' second charge timeout of the half. We'll be back after a short break.
That's one top.
We invite all our fans tonight to go buy our Charger Grill, our world-winning, famous Charger Grill, and fill yourself up with some great treats tonight.
Back here, 58 seconds, fourth and two. The Eagles poised to go for it here.
Ethan Williams in the backfield. Devereaux to take the snap.
Dever trying to draw them off sides. And it looks like they're going to call a false start on the Eagles. And that's going to kill any chance of converting the first down as Eagles will bring on the punt team. Now it's fourth and seven on the 23. 58 seconds still left on the clock. So Dallas Christian still has some time to work with one timeout to try and get in scoring position before the half.
Montoya with a big leg, but punting into wind. We'll see how far Montoya can get this ball. 58 seconds left on the clock. Still a lot of time for the Chargers to get something going. Ball on the 23-yard line.
Montoya with a high punt. That's going to be caught around the 45-yard line with a fair catch by Scott. With 51 seconds here, the Chargers and Kearney are going to get back on offense, but a penalty marker is on the field. There's going to be a holding on the return, so that's going to bring the spot of the ball back about 10 yards from the hold.
And that holding call will put the ball in their own territory for the Chargers. Big break here for the Eagles as 10 yards could be the difference between 0 and 7 points for the Chargers offense. First down for the Chargers at their own 45-yard line.
Against the Chargers. Holding a call against the Chargers.
Eagle defense will set up against the Chargers.
Brings up first and 10 from the Chargers' own 45.
Been very successful on the defensive side of the ball ever since that first drive in the first quarter. Very early on in the game, the Eagles have made adjustments. And since then, the Chargers really have had no success. Jackson, what has contributed to the Eagles' success on defense tonight?
Getting after the quarterback has been a huge part of the defense. Ivan Jimmy Ducks with a nice scramble. Both get after the quarterback and done a great job at that. We'll see if they can get after the quarterback here. As Luke Kearney's backing shotgun, two receivers up top. He's going to be a quarterback draw here. And he's going to get up. He's going to get a first down here up to about the 44-yard line. And that's going to momentarily stop the clock while they move the chains.
One timeout left for the Chargers that they can use. Clock will stop momentarily as they move the chains. A flag on the play coming in very late.
Penalty marker on the play.
It's going to be against the Eagles.
It appears it's going to be an unsportsmanlike. I believe something was said by number 72, Jalen Zuber.
We'll see what the call is from the official. I believe you're right, Jackson, as number 72 jogged off the field shortly after the flag was thrown. Flag still on the field around the line of scrimmage.
Dead ball. Unsportsmanlike, number 72 of the defense. 15 yards from the end of the play. First down.
He was standing right next to the official, so he must have said something that was inappropriate. But that's a killer, and that's going to bring the ball all the way up to the 30-yard line.
Definitely something the officials didn't like, but that's a huge break for this Charger offense. Brings the ball to the 29-yard line. 41 seconds left on the clock.
41 seconds left, 29 yards to go for Kearney and the Chargers. He's in shotgun. He evades the pressure once, but he's going to get brought down by Granville and a host of Eagles in the backfield as the clock runs, but Dallas Christian will immediately call a timeout with 29 seconds left. What a play.
Great play there from 55, Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth, and number 13, Max Granville in the backfield once again, putting pressure on number 9, Luke Kearney. Dallas Christian coaching staff wanted a late hit call there on the Eagle defense, but momentum was already moving forward. There was no stopping that. Clean defense from the Eagles. Chargers take a timeout. 29 seconds left on the clock. 14-7, your Eagles lead. Ball on the 29-yard line. We'll be right back.
Oh,
we're back at Wheeler Stadium. Before play resumes, just want to give a big shout out to Dallas Christian for providing us with microphones tonight so we could do this broadcast. Our microphones were left at home.
Luke Carney in shotgun as he looks down the sideline. And that one's going to be incomplete. Kobe Sellers was in on the coverage there of Nettles. That's going to bring up third and 10.
Carney's pass intended for number
Nettles
three.
Appeared to fall into Kobe Sellers on the route.
It's going to bring up third down at 16 for the Chargers.
Third and 16 to go. 23 seconds on the clock. Chargers looking to advance the ball downfield about 35 yards.
Just 23 seconds left to go here in this second, in this first half. We'll see if the Chargers just try and get for a closer field goal or if they're going to go for the first down. Carney is in shotgun here. Hernandez is the back as Nettles is by himself down low. Carney keeps it on his own read. And he's going to get up for a first down. What a run by the quarterback.
No timeouts here for the Chargers. They're going to have to hurry up and spike the ball.
Dallas Christian gets the spike down with just 4 seconds falling off the clock. There's 12 seconds left here. It's now second and 10 on the 17-yard line.
Carney spikes the ball.
They'll have time for about two, maybe three quick plays to the end zone, but they'll definitely have at least two shots to the end zone. But so far tonight, most of the Chargers' offense has been on the ground.
On the ground and from Luke Carney, really. Number nine with that read option. He's gotten several yards with 20-plus yards. Several rushes with 20-plus yards. That read option has been killer for the Eagles' defense tonight. We'll see if they even go back to that here with about 20 yards to go for the Chargers.
A flag is now thrown as we're going to have a delay of game call as the Chargers are out of timeouts and cannot stop the penalty. That's going to back them up to about the 15-yard line now.
14-7 with 12 seconds on the clock.
Excuse me, the ball is now on the 23-yard line.
Any loss of yardage hurts the Chargers offense here. With 24 to go, Chargers look to attack the end zone.
Nettles is in motion. Carney fakes the handoff, and he's got a man wide open over the middle, and that's going to be caught for a touchdown. Number five, Zane Tolliver on the catch, and that's going to probably tie the game at 14 with 6 seconds to go in the half. What a throw by Carney.
Great play from Dallas Christian heading into halftime, and you got to think that the Eagles are second-guessing their decision to throw the ball on third and two with a minute left in this first half. Could have ran down the clock with the ball in their own possession, but instead a false start call from Brian Domino forces a punt for the Eagles, and the Chargers capitalize with a touchdown.
Number 44, Jake Lowry, in to take the extra point. It is up and it is good. With 6 seconds to go in the half, the Chargers tie it up at 14. What a great drive there by the Chargers and great plays by Carney.
When it seems like all hope has been lost for the Eagles, you do have to remember that the Eagles do get the ball to start the second half. So if there's anything positive coming out of this second quarter, it's that they do start with the ball in the second half, hopefully looking to get some momentum back at halftime after defeating into this second quarter. 14-14, we're now tied at Wheeler Field here in Dallas.
Eagle coverage unit taking the field now. As they look, we'll probably just let the clock run out here to end the half and look to regroup. Dallas Christian kick team about to take the field here. That drive was fueled by the unsportsmanlike conduct of Jalen Zuber. That really crushed the drive and gave a lot of momentum to the Chargers and led to the touchdown. Big loss there for the Eagles. And that's Zuber's first unsportsmanlike of the game.
And you gotta realize, penalties have truly killed the Eagle defense tonight. That drive could have easily been prevented by the Eagle defense, but the unsportsmanlike conduct from Jalen Zuber
as well as penalties on the offensive side of the field that prevented the Eagles from getting a first down on the previous drive, really contributed to the Chargers scoring on that previous drive. We'll see what the Eagles can do. 6 seconds left. The Eagles look to return the kick.
Lowry in to send it away. Sellers is back deep for the Eagles. Lowry's going to kick it low and far. Sellers on the bounce. He's going to look to make a return. He's going to take it to the low side of the field as the clock's going to hit triple zeros as he gets tackled out of bounds at the 25-yard line. But a penalty marker is in on the play. Depending on who the flag is on, we may see an untimed down here. But I believe that flag is going to get picked up and we're going to go to half.
Eagles already jogging off the field and the Chargers will follow right behind them. That flag will be waved off. 14-14 is your score here at Wheeler Field. A great game tonight. Eagles and Chargers going at it. Two evenly matched teams. We'll see you after halftime.
24 minutes for halftime. We'll be back after a break. Do not go anywhere, folks. We've got a game. 14-14.
Penalty is declined on the play. That's the end of our first half. Chargers 14, Eagles 14. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please direct your attention to the east end of our stadium. Tonight, we are dedicating our new Pat and Herb Gibson and Jimmy and Melinda Dell video scoreboard. These two families made our dream of a video board come true with their very generous and significant gift. Pat and Herb Gibson were one of the foundational families that sustained Dallas Christian in her early years. Their vision, commitment, and financial support to Christian education and to Dallas Christian have touched thousands of DC graduates over the decades. The Gibson legacy is extended generationally at DC with 4 alumni kids, 9 alumni grandkids, and 5 alumni great-grandkids. This is a total of 18 graduates from Dallas Christian School. Joining us tonight on the field representing the Gibson family is Mike and Terry Gibson, Bill and Cynthia Rudd, Pam and Jim Kirk, Jeff Kirk, April Roberts, 6th grader Crosby Roberts, and 11th grader Brindley Kirk. Also joining us on the field tonight are Jimmy and Melinda Dale. The Dales are also a great DC family and faithful supporters. You will notice the sign under our press box in honor of both Jimmy and Melinda's parents. The Dale family made our football stadium renovation possible. Jimmy and Melinda's son, Tyner Dale, class of 2019, came to DC in middle school. He was not only a great academic student, but also a great leader for our football program. Tyner earned a scholarship to play football in college at the Colorado School of Mines. We are proud of Tyner and his accomplishments. The Dale family has a heart for the kingdom of God and Dallas Christian School. We are thankful for their continued support and their generosity. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in recognizing these two outstanding Charger families. Fort Bend Christian Pep Band. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the field your Dallas Christian varsity cheerleaders. For our varsity cheerleaders. Now introducing senior co-captain Alyssa Harvey, junior Brinley Kirk. Brinley received the Star Jumper Award and All-American Cheerleader. Junior Chloe Johnson. Chloe received the top All-American Cheerleader Award as well as Star Jumper and Star Tumbler. Senior co-captain Emma Grace Burke. Senior Haley Pope. Senior Kennedy Chapel. Senior Laney Sy. Junior Morgan Tillett. And senior Olivia Kelly. Let's hear it one more time for your 2022 varsity cheerleaders.
She's my mind, so excited, she's my good.
We are just 1 minute away from the second half, starting back up. 14-14 is your score here. Eagles, Chargers jumped out to a quick 7-0 lead in their first drive. The Eagles kept on hitting away on the offense. It got up to a 14-7 lead before the Chargers had a last second touchdown with 6 seconds to go in the second quarter to tie it up at 14. The Eagles will receive the ball here on the opening kickoff as they won the toss. So we're in for a great finish here in the second half. So do not go anywhere. My name is Jackson Champion. I'm joined with by Derek Jordan. What have you seen so far, Derek, that you've liked from the offense?
From the offense, it's been a lot of production from Brady Dever. Him running the ball and a few times throwing the ball downfield. Completed passes to Brian Domino mostly. Him, the read option has been a great tool for Brady Dever as well, really catching the defense off guard. Unfortunately, the read option has also been a very effective tool for Dallas Christian, catching our defense off guard.
I was about to say, Dallas Christian's offense, they've followed just slugging so far that you see from Dallas Christian and how they move the ball, especially quarterback Carney.
Luke Carney's had a great game so far. He has the ability to really use his speed. And Carney has broken that field several times for a big game. Running backs Hernandez and Scott have both been critical parts of the Chargers offense as well. Both with huge games on the game. And Carney's arm has also been getting it done so far tonight, accounting for several yards and 2 touchdowns. So we'll see how the Eagles can adapt. Defenses look good for the Eagles, Jackson. What have the Eagles done so far on defense that you've liked, and what can they improve on?
They've done a great job of getting after the quarterback. D-Lyman, Ivan Jimmy Duxworth, and Max Grandville have been awesome so far tonight, each having about 2 sacks already. They've been having a lot of pressures. Luke Carney's been on the run. The only thing the Eagles have had trouble with on defense is defending the quarterback run. Carney's done a great job reading the defense and keeping and giving on certain plays. So it'll be interesting to see if they're going to be more keen on the quarterback on certain run plays. But early in the game, they were not ready for the quarterback keeper. On defense for the Chargers, they've done a great job eliminating the Brady Dever and his passing. But late in the second quarter, Dever started to figure them out. And early in the game, they were doing a great job stopping the run at the line of scrimmage. And now Ethan Williams was starting to pluck away later in the game. So we'll see if the Eagles can keep wearing that offensive line with Bennett Warren, Lucas Vargas, Aiden Rhodes, some great players on that line, Nathan Robinson, Jalen Zuber. Let's see if they can keep weighing away at that Dallas Christian defensive line and make an impact.
And Kobe Sellers with the Eagles' biggest offensive play of the game. We'll see if he's utilized any more than he was in the first half on offense. Number one will be back to receive the kick. Eagles kickoff return out on the field. Looking to take on the Charger kickoff team. Officials having a bit of a discussion with the chain manager on the Eagles sideline.
Now that the chains are set, Jake Lauer is set to kick this one away with Kobe Sellers and Braylon Gardone back deep on their own 15-yard lines. The official gives the whistle Lowry for play.
Call for the Chargers.
And Lowry sends this one away with a nice line drive kick to Gardone, which is fielded at about the 14-yard line. Gardone makes a cut up field. He gets past the 35-yard line before being tripped up and stopped right around the 39-yard line.
Gardone saw a lot of green turf ahead of him. If he had broken that one tackle, he would have been gone, Jackson. That would have been 7 for the Eagles on the first play of this half. But Gardone still with a very successful return, getting down to the 39-yard line, almost in Charger territory. 8 seconds off the clock. Brady Devers back on the field to lead the Eagle offense.
Eagles lining up back in the pistol here. With Kobe Sellers in at the running back. Low snap, but Devers is going to have his knee down when he picked up the ball. And that play is going to be dead for a loss of about 5 yards.
Not a great start for the Eagle offense here in this second half. Loss of 5 yards. It'll be second down and very long for the Eagles. The Eagles have converted a few second and longs, third and longs, fourth and longs in the first half. So we'll see what they can do with 15 to go here.
Eagles bunching up close here with just one receiver wide up top. Trips down low. Devers going to toss it out to Ethan Williams on the wide side. And Ethan Williams is going to be upended around the 44-yard line. That's going to be a nice gain of about 10 yards.
Great play there from Ethan Williams, and he started to gain more and more yards later on in the first half. Starting the game, wasn't much production there from Ethan Williams, but later on in the half, he started to find a stride, started to break up field. He saw a hole there, and he hit it. Ethan Williams with a great gain for the Eagles.
Brady Devers in shotgun. He hands it off to Williams. Williams bounces it outside as he's going to get nowhere. He's going to lose a yard in the play, and that's going to bring up fourth down. Great stop there by the Chargers defensive line.
Number 79 coming in there on the tackle for the Chargers. Williams tried to cut to the other side of the field, and 79 met him there with a force. Fourth and 7 for the Eagles. Emmanuel Montoya will come on to punt as the offensive unit comes off the field. Eagles stopped on this first offensive drive of the half. We'll see what they can do after the punt here on defense.
Montoya in to punt it. Two returners back deep for Christian as Montoya booms this one deep. That was going to take a beautiful Eagle bounce, and it's going to go all the way down to the 10-yard line. What a great punt by Montoya. Nearly a 50-yard punt.
Magical punt there from Emmanuel Montoya, putting the Eagle defense in great position. Chargers having to start from their own 10-yard line. As we've seen from the first half, the Chargers can move the ball quickly if the Eagle defense lets up for even one play. So, Chargers taking over from their own 10-yard line. We'll be back after a short break.
Luke Carney in a quarterback in a shotgun. Zach Hernandez is the tailback. He's going to fake the handoff to the wide receiver. And he's going to break up field for a nice gain before being tackled right around the 30-yard line. Great gain there for about 20 yards.
And as we talked about before we started this second half, Jackson, Luke Carney is dangerous on his feet.
Kobe Sellers limps off the field. That's not a good sign for the Eagles, as he's one of the most electric players and one of their better defensive backs on the team.
As definitely the fastest person on this Eagle roster, it's a danger to see Kobe Sellers limping off. That means something on his lower half is probably not all right. We'll see what the Eagles do to adjust without Sellers.
First and 10 for Carney. Carney motions out. Hernandez, he's going to keep it again. He's going to break down the sideline. He's going to make a move before being dragged out of bounds by Jordan Rogers right around midfield. Another nice gain. That's going to pick up another 20 yards.
Brought down by number 21, Rogers. Penalty marker on the play.
Penalty flag in the backfield around the line of scrimmage.
We'll have a false start on the offense. That play should have been blown dead. But Luke Kearney's run up the field will come back. Huge break for the Eagles as the Eagles reset after losing Kobe Sellers for a play.
Due to a false start, the offense was lined up in the neutral zone. 5 yards, still first down.
Before the play even started, one of the linemen was lined up in the neutral zone. So the play was deemed dead at the snap, a loss of 5 yards, and that's going to back them up to the 25-yard line. Excuse me, the 23-yard. What a big swing from being at midfield all the way back down to first and 15 from the 23-yard line.
A bit of shift here on the Eagle defense as Ben Longbottom has moved to cornerback in place of Kobe Sellers, and number 7, Braylon Gardoni has come into the game to play that free safety position.
Kearney in shock. He's going to hand it off to Hernandez to the wide side. He's going to get up back to the original line of scrimmage for a gain of about 5 yards. That's going to bring up 2nd and 10.
Great tackle from number 9, Connor Tallis, playing that linebacker position. He has a great read of the backfield. Usually pursues very well. Alignment assignments both very good for Connor Tallis. Transfer from George Ranch. He's already fit in well with this Eagle defense.
2nd and 9 to go here for the Chargers. Kearney is in shotgun yet again with Hernandez to his right. Kearney looks deep. He's going to evade pressure. He's going to dance around the pocket. And he's going to be met by number
By number 20.
Great play from number 32, Jacob Yarnield, to make the tackle along with James Donovan, number 6.
Loss of a yard on the play. 3rd down and 10.
Loss of a yard for the Chargers. Luke Kearney having to scramble a little bit.
3rd and 10 now as a loss of a yard there brings up a big play here for the Eagle defense and the Charger offense. Kearney's in shotgun with Hernandez to his left. Kearney rolls out to the bottom. He throws a wobbly pass toward the sideline. That's going to be incomplete with Matthew Brown in coverage.
Great play there from Matthew Brown. Dallas Christian coaching staff calling for a pass interference, but the referees didn't see anything. Clean play from number 25. We have an injured Eagle in the backfield, and that's not good. That's number 13, Max Granville.
We'll pause for a brief entry timeout.
Max Granville walks off the field on his own power after cramping on the play. Should re-enter the game soon.
7:35 here left in the third quarter. As it's 4th and 10 now for the Chargers.
And we'll once again mention that the Eagles did arrive here just 30 minutes before kickoff was supposed to take place. Got stuck in some really bad traffic on the way here.
Back deep to receive the punt is number 7, senior receiver Braylon Gardoni. As I mentioned earlier, Kobe Sellers limped off the field earlier. That's why you're not seeing him. I wonder if the injury is severe. We'll check in later on his status. A punt by Kearney is going to be high. It's going to be caught by Gardoni right around the 45. And the Eagle offense will set up shop in their own territory.
Fair caught by Gardoni at the 45-yard line.
High punt there from Kearney. Kearney not really getting a whole lot of good snaps when he punts the ball. One that went over his head that set up an Eagle touchdown after Jordan Rogers read and got a tackle deep in Charger territory. We'll see if the Chargers can make an adjustment there. Eagle defense taking over from the 45-yard line inside their own territory.
Ethan Williams is going to line up as an in-line tight end here. Devers in the shotgun. Devers looking deep for Domino. Domino has his man beat, and it's caught, and that's a touchdown for Brian Domino.
Great throw from Brady Devers down the field to Brian Domino, and that's an electric play for the Eagle offense. And if there's any way to create momentum in football, it's a play like that. First play of the drive, 55-yard pass from Brady Devers to Brian Domino. 20-14 is your score. The Eagles now have the lead.
What a throw by Devers and what a route by Domino. He torches defender. And that's the case. If he's even, he's leaving. What a route by Domino.
Great throw there downfield. That's the first deep ball that Brady Devers has completed this game. Second touchdown pass to Brian Domino on the season. And that's a huge momentum shift for the Eagles. After going into halftime with a bit of a momentum shift towards the Chargers, after some penalties cost the Eagles a drive and then the Chargers scored a touchdown, that is the way the Eagles respond. 21-14, 7:19 on the clock. Eagles have the lead.
What a shift in momentum there. One play, one touchdown for the Eagles. And there just showed you the electric play of Brian Domino, who has multiple offers on the year already from a couple colleges. That could be the play that sends off his college radar and booms his status. Brian Domino had an amazing year last year, catching over 1,000 yards and about 18 touchdowns. He was an amazing player, Devers' favorite target on the year as a junior. Him and Devers came both from Foster High School out in Richmond, Texas. Both grew up as childhood friends, and you can definitely see that connection paying off on the field from that last touchdown.
And that's the kind of plays the Eagles offense need to make against this Dallas Charger defense, which has truly been relentless this game.
Montoya set to send it away as he does not get all of that ball. That one's going to be caught around the 25-yard line. Number 7 is going to bounce it outside, but he's going to be tackled out of bounds by Montoya at the 49-yard line as the kicker saves a huge play that could have been for the Chargers.
Not a great kick from number 19, Emmanuel Montoya. That's really his first missed kickoff of the year. I really do not think that the short kick was intentional. Had a lot of arc on it, very high kick, but unfortunately the Chargers do capitalize. They're going to be at the 49-yard line in their own territory. Eagle defense looking to make another stop here as they play their first drive without Max Granville.
For all of you watching, Kobe Sellers, an injury update, he's back on the field at corner, but Max Granville is still on the sideline.
He's stretching out a little bit. Hopefully we'll return to the game soon. Hopefully injury nothing serious.
Carney in shotgun. He's going to keep it on the zone read, and he's going to be upended by number 11, Keenum Self, for a gain of about 4 yards.
Aggressive tackle there from Keenum Self. Chiso Ajoku coming into the game for Max Granville. We'll see how he can really fill the shoes of Granville in that right end position.
Second and 6 here with 6:40 roughly to go here in the third quarter. Eagles lead 21-14 over the Dallas Christian Chargers. Dallas Christian. Carney is in shotgun. He hands it off to Hernandez as Hernandez immediately met by Chiso Ajoku right at the line of scrimmage.
Great tackle there from number 44, Ajoku, to stop the run from Hernandez. Number two, Eagle defensive line has been very good this game, not allowing too many yards on the run. Having a little trouble reading the read option from Carney. Carney takes it for several yards, several times this game. But besides that, Eagle front has been very strong.
Third and 6 to go here. The Chargers are back in shotgun. Carney takes the snap. He looks downfield and he moves around the pocket. He escapes Bjornjell and he makes it around the end. But he's going to be pushed out of bounds. Right around the 43-yard line, he's going to be short of a first down.
Great play in the backfield from Jacob Bjornjell to slow down the momentum of Luke Carney to allow Connor Tallis and Keenum Self to pursue on the quarterback,
preventing the first down. Fourth down and short to go. We'll see what the call is from the offensive coordinator and the head coach for the Chargers. Let's see if they're going to go for it here, if they're going to punt it away to the Eagles.
Fourth and two. This is definitely go-for-it territory. Let's see if they try and just draw them offside here. There's 10 seconds on the play clock. Down to 5 seconds as the Chargers look to the sideline. 3, 2, 1, and a timeout will be called by head coach Wheeler before the delay of game. As the Chargers were just looking to draw the Eagles offsides there.
In a close game like this, it's not something you want to do is burn your timeouts early on. You might want to save those for later on in the game. Chargers burn one right there. Two timeouts left. 5:27 on the clock. Your score is 21-14 in favor of your FBCA Eagles. We'll be back.
Trots back out here on 4th and 2 as they're staying in a regular formation. It looks like they'll go for it here. We'll see if the Eagle defense can stand strong against Luke Kearney and the Chargers. Watch out for the zone read here. Kearney drops back and it's a quarterback draw. He's going to pick up the first down and a couple more yards and bring it down to the 37-yard line.
Delayed blitz from Connor Tallis on the left side of the line. Unfortunately, Kearney took off, evaded the pressure, and escaped the pocket just before Taz was able to get to him in the backfield. So that'll be a first down for the Chargers on their own in Eagle territory now at the 37-yard line.
First and 10 now for the Chargers. Kearney starting to move the ball now. Two backfield set as Hernandez is motioned out. It's going to be a handoff to Scott. He's going to jiggle up down to around the pass for a first down for about 11 yards.
Good run there from Scott to get a first down for the Chargers. It seems as if the momentum has shifted back towards Dallas Christian. Eagles in need of a big stop here as Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth now limps off the field. That's not something you want to see.
First and 10 now on the 26-yard line. For the Chargers, Kearney's got the offense moving as they'll keep the two-back set with Scott and Hernandez. Same play as last, but Scott does not get anywhere there as he stopped at the line for a gain of zero, and that's going to bring up second down.
Good tackle from Jalen Zuber and Jackson Praying. As you can see, folks, Eagle defense currently running without Kobe Sellers, without Ivan Jimmy Ducksworth, and without Max Granville.
No gain on the play. Second down and 10.
We'll see how the backups can do against this Dallas Christian offense, showing resistance right now.
Second and 10 now. Chargers keeping the same formation with an inline tight end now. Hernandez is motioned out. It's a quarterback draw for Kearney. He makes a huge hole up the middle, and he's going to be get past the 10-yard line, and he's going to be tackled around the 6-yard line, and that's going to bring up first and goal for the Chargers.
Kearney getting it done with his feet when the air attack has really not been working for the Chargers. A lot of different things the Chargers have been doing with the run game. A lot of it coming from Luke Kearney, but mixing in Hernandez and Scott as well. We'll see if the Eagles can make an adjustment here. Prevent the touchdown on first and goal for the Chargers.
Worth noting, William Nettles has not had much opportunity on the offensive end. The Eagles have done a great job containing him. Scott's motioned out. It's going to be a handoff to Hernandez up the middle, and he's going to score for a touchdown, and that's going to bring the game within 1 point.
Great run there from Hernandez. That's going to be his second touchdown of the night. Defensive line couldn't get it done on that drive. Without Jimmy Ducksworth at Granville, they'll look to come back on the next drive. Kobe Sellers also bouncing around on the sidelines. looking to get warm once again, recover from whatever injury he suffered earlier on this quarter. Number 44 will come on to kick the extra point for the Chargers.
3:09 left here in the third quarter as Lowry's in to kick the extra point. The snap is bobbled, and it's going to be pitched up by... Oh, it's going to be missed by Jordan Rodgers. There's a flag on the play. And if he picked up that ball, nobody was catching him. What a smart play by Brown to punch that ball as opposed to getting to try to get somebody else to pick it up. But a flag is on the play.
Very high IQ play there from Brown. Unfortunately, Rodgers could not scoop and score the football. We'll see what the flag is. Maybe the officials thought Brown kicked the football, which would be a penalty against the Eagles. But the fumbled snap does keep the Eagles in the lead.
Illegal batting by the defense. Try's no good.
They're going to call an illegal batting on Matthew Brown for showing no intent to grab the ball there. There's going to be no good. As the score is going to remain 21-20, the Eagles are still in the lead after a huge special teams play there and a huge miscue by the Chargers.
And any lead is positive here for the Eagles as they're holding on by the skin of their teeth. 21-20 is your score here, folks. 3 minutes left on the clock here in this third quarter. We've got ourselves a ball game. We'll be right back.
While your feet are stumping and the jam is pumping, look at here, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you'll find out if you do that.
For 3:09 left here in the third quarter, Fort Bend Christian Academy leads Dallas Christian 21-20 after a missed extra point by a failed snap by the Chargers. The Chargers drove down the field quite well off the backs of quarterback Luke Carney's running and brought the game within 1 point. The Eagles are set to get the ball back here as Kobe Sellers and Braylon Gardoni are back deep to receive as Lowry is set to send it away for the Chargers. That one's going to be kicked out to Gardoni, caught around the 5-yard line. As he's going to make a return, he's going to break up the sideline past the 30-yard line, and he's going to hit out of bounds at right at the 30-yard line.
Good return there from Gardoni. That's his second 30-yard-plus return for the Eagles on the kickoff. Chargers not kicking it much to the side of Kobe Sellers this game, as he had a punt return and a kickoff return in the last game, both for a touchdown. We'll see what the Eagles can do on offense here. We'll see number 20, Sorrell Taylor, come into the game.
Taylor lined up out at wide receiver with his primary position being a running back. Ethan Williams lined up at tailback next to Brady Dever in shotgun. Brian Domino's alone up top. Brady Dever drops back in shotgun. He's immediately pressured. He steps up, but he's going to be taken down in the backfield by Dallas Christian for a huge sack.
That'll be a loss of about 10 yards for the Eagles on the play. Great pressure there from the Dallas Christian defensive front.
Devontae High causes the 5-yard sack, and that's going to bring up 2nd and 15 now for the Eagles.
Eagles looking to respond here. Another big play. Maybe an order from Brady Dever to Brian Domino. In case you missed it on the last drive, the two connected for a 55-yard touchdown score.
Dallas Christian pressing the receivers. Dever hands it off to Williams. Williams is tackled again by High, maybe for 2 yards. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 13 now as Ethan Williams' helmet comes off.
Williams' second time his helmet has come off this game, and he's going to hobble off the field. Not a good thing you want to see. Here in the second half, a lot of Eagles limping off the field with injuries, with cramps. Not a lot of time to warm up for the Eagles tonight. Really testing the endurance and the conditioning of this Eagle team. Domino and Gardoni both on the right side of the offense at receiver.
Devers in shotgun with Taylor lined up as the back. Donovan and Currier lined up top. Dever fakes the toss. There's a screen out to Gardoni. That one's going to be blown up behind the line of scrimmage by number three, William Nettles, as Brian Domino. Oh, no. As the Eagles go three and out there, as they're going to be looking to punt back to the Chargers.
Great defense there from the Chargers. Will Nettles with a great defensive play to stop Gardoni. Design screen pass to Gardoni with blocking up front. Nettles read it like a book and got the tackle on Gardoni for only a gain of about a yard.
Montoya in the punt as he sends this one out to the 40-yard line. It's not fair. It's going to be a great tackle by number 25, Matthew Brown, and he's upended right where he caught it. What great punt coverage.
On almost every punt that Emmanuel Montoya has, Matthew Brown is down the field making the tackle. A fair catch is not called. He did it several times last week, and he's done it several times tonight. Matthew Brown with an electric play for the Eagles. And number 13, Max Granville, is back on the field, along with number 55, Ivan Jimmy Duxworth, and Kobe Sellers on the far end of your screen at cornerback.
And at linebacker for the Eagles, you see Caleb Bratcher, along with number 9, Connor Tallis, both George Ranch prospects. Luke Carney's back in at shotgun with Hernandez to his right. He'll hand it off to Hernandez, and he's going to be pushed up to about the 43-yard line for a gain of about 5.
Great tackle there from Ivan Jimmy Duxworth, already making a difference after coming out of the game for a short break after a cramp or an injury. That'll be a gain of about 5 yards on the play. Second down and 5 for the Chargers coming up.
This will likely be the last play of the third quarter as we are under 40 seconds. At about 30 seconds left, Carney's in shotgun. Carney hands it off to Hernandez yet again. And that's going to, he's going to be tackled, and he's going to gain about a yard. That's going to bring up 3rd and 4.
Caleb Bratcher now limping. Seems to have a bit of a cramp in his quad. Trying to walk it off before this next play. Bratcher will now jog off the field as number 11, Keenum Self, checks back into the game.
And that's going to be the end of the third quarter. Eagles lead the Chargers 21-20. Don't go anywhere, folks. We've got a ball game. 1-point game here in Dallas. We'll be right back. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV. Folks, 21-20. You've got 12 minutes left in the game. It all comes down to this. The Eagles lead by 1 over the Chargers. The Chargers have the ball here as we flip sides of the field. As it is 3rd and 4 now for Luke Carney in the offense. As he's got Zach Hernandez with him in the backfield. Eagles stack a lot in the box. And they're going to fake it. It's going to be a fumble. It's going to be put on the deck. It's going to be picked up by Max Granville, and that's going to be a turnover.
Granville almost had the scoop and score there, just couldn't stay on his feet and made the smart decision to just go down with the ball. Eagles now with great field position, looking to score again and extend this lead.
What a huge play by the Eagles, and what a change of momentum. Eagles are just on the Charger 24-yard line, and now they're on offense with the Chargers looking to convert there. It's a total change.
So what was 3rd and 4 for the Chargers is now 1st and 10 for the Eagles after the fumble. Great defensive play from the defensive front of Fort Bend Christian Academy. Max Granville clearly making his presence known.
Devers back in shotgun now. He's looking for Gardoni. He's going to be tackled by Nettles, and there's going to be no flag on the play as the referee's going to say that Gardoni just tripped on his own. That's going to be 2nd and 10.
Gardoni was tackled by Will Nettles on that throw, and no flag thrown. Missed pass interference call, and Coach Black is visibly upset with the referees.
Brings up 2nd down and 10 for the Eagles.
Kobe Sellers now coming in on offense as Ethan Williams and Tyler Curry check off.
Eagles looking to make up for that play. Could have been a touchdown, or at least a first down, after a missed pass interference call.
Eagles love to run out of the pistol. Kobe Sellers is the tailback. Dever tosses it to the wide side. He's going to be a fake pass to Sellers, and that's going to be caught by Gardoni. Oh, it's going to be dropped. One referee is ruling a touchdown. The other is ruling an incomplete pass. Clear confusion on the field between the officials as Kobe Sellers threw the ball to Gardoni. As Gardoni went to the ground, the ball appeared to pop out of his hands. It appeared he did not maintain control to the ground. I believe that's the call the far side officials making, but the official that was right there by the play is calling touchdown.
And a call on the field is going to be an incomplete pass, I believe. No, it's going to be a touchdown for the Eagles. They're going to say that the ball came out after he hit the ground, and that's going to be a touchdown for Fort Bend Christian Academy.
Within just 30 seconds of the fourth quarter, we've seen some crazy plays happen, and as the referee now signals touchdown. And keep in mind, we're in high school. There's no instant replay. There's no changing that. There's no looking at it. So if you look at it, you may see an incomplete pass, but in high school, you can't go back and change and look at it.
Emmanuel Montoya on to kick the extra point here. Chiso Ajoku will jog on the field.
Montoya on for
extra point protection.
Eagles looking to make it an 8-point lead now over the Chargers. Montoya on to kick it up. Kick it away, and it's up and good. An 8-point lead now for the Eagles with a huge play by backup quarterback Kobe Sellers on the fake to throw it to Gardone. He was wide open in the end zone for a touchdown. 28-20 is your score. We'll be back after a short break. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV. Don't go anywhere. Back here in the fourth quarter, Emmanuel Montoya set to send it away for the Eagles. That one's going to be high to Nettles around the 10-yard line, the dangerous return man. Nettles is going to get past the 25, make a spin move. He'll be tackled around the 30-yard line as he'll gain 5 yards from a touchback.
Emmanuel Montoya with his 2nd tackle on the kickoff tonight.
stopping the return from number 3, Will Nettles. Primarily a cornerback, but Will Nettles can play wide receiver and also play special teams. Truly an all-around football player and an athlete. Number 3 has definitely made a difference for this Charger team, along with stars Luke Kearney and Hernandez in the backfield. Eagle defense looking to make another big stop here. After the fumble on the last defensive drive, the Eagles truly gained some momentum and extended their lead to 8 points. Eagles now lead 28-20 as the Chargers take the field for offense.
Kearney in shotgun with Hernandez to his right. 3 receivers down low, 1 up top. Chargers looking to respond. Kearney in shotgun fakes the screen. Both screens are not open as he throws to Hernandez. It's immediately broken up by Connor Tallis behind the line. And that's going to be incomplete. What a great play by the senior transfer linebacker.
Great play from Connor Tallis, but also great pressure from the defensive line. Kearney had to escape the pocket almost instantly. Kearney threw the ball off to the only receiver he could find, and Tallis with great pressure on the running back to make that an incomplete pass. It'll be 2nd down and 10 for the Chargers.
Chargers have the ball on their own 33-yard line with 11:18 left to go here in the fourth quarter. Chargers down by 8. They need a touchdown and a 2-point conversion to tie it. Nettles is in motion. Kearney will fake the handoff and keep it, and he's going to be tackled just for about a gain of 2 on the quarterback keeper, and that's going to bring up 3rd and 8.
Eagles reading the read option much better on this drive. Only a 2-yard gain compared to a 1st down and more that has happened several times this game on the read option from Kearney. Eagles making a great adjustment here. Defensive line playing well, reading well, and linebackers especially. Really the quarterbacks of this defense right now.
3rd and 8 here to go. Chargers need a big 1st down here to keep the momentum going. The Eagles may march right back down, score another touchdown. Big play here for the offense. Kearney drops back. He has a man wide open downfield, and that's going to be caught for a 1st down by number 4, Austin Ellis.
Good route there from Ellis, and also a good tackle from Ben Longbottom. Unfortunately, couldn't get to him before Chargers got a 1st down. That'll be a 1st down as they advance the ball. They're now at the 45-yard line in their own territory.
That's one of the few times that we've seen the Chargers throw downfield tonight and complete it. They have not been successful throwing the ball so far tonight as opposed to Brady Devereaux's success. 1st and 10 now from the 45. Kearney motions a receiver, fakes the handoff. He's looking deep yet again. He's got a man wide open right around the sticks, and that's caught by Nettles. And he's going to push his way forward for another 5 yards, and that's going to bring it up to about the 37-yard line. Another 1st down for the Chargers.
Dallas Christian offense really producing in this fourth quarter on this drive. Attacking in the air right now as the Eagles made an adjustment on the ground. The Chargers look to the air for production here, and it has worked so far on this drive. 2 1st downs in 2 plays. Eagles look to make an adjustment in the secondary now.
1st and 10 from the 37. Kearney's in shotgun. Receiver's motion, a handoff is faked, and Kearney will keep it on the draw. And he's going to get up for another 1st down and more. And he's going to be tackled around the 22-yard line after picking up another 1st down.
Good hit there from Jordan Rogers to stop the momentum of Luke Kearney. But once again, another 1st down on the read option. On almost every play this drive, the Chargers have been working with motion. It's really throwing the Eagles' defense off guard. They don't know where they're going. Play action has worked quite well for the Chargers. Really just confusing the Eagle defense right now. They don't know what to expect.
9:15 left to go here in the fourth quarter. The Chargers are moving the ball with authority. 1st and 10 now from the 22. 2 receivers up top, but a timeout is now going to be called by the Eagles to stop the Charger momentum. Score is 28-20 with 9:06 left in the fourth. You're watching Eagles on the Air on FBCA TV.
There's a new price on the Nothing But Cake Buntinis for supporting the Dallas Christian Fine Arts Department. 1 for $2 and 12 for $20 while supplies last. Grab your Buntinis tonight.
beginning to know, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became a summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along?
Weather doesn't get much better than this on a Friday night in Dallas. Just around 80 degrees. The wind has died. A beautiful night for football and a beautiful night to finish up this game. 28-20 is your score. The Chargers are on offense. Kearney hands it off to Hernandez to the wide side, and he's going to break one tackle but not get past Jordan Rodgers and Keene himself, as he's going to be tackled behind the line, and that's going to bring up second and 11.
Great read from Matthew Brown to stop the momentum of Hernandez, make a play in the backfield, stumbles him a little bit. That makes room for Tallis and Jordan Rodgers to come make a play. Number one, Scott will come back into the game as the play is called. We'll see if the Chargers continue to use the motion on offense in this drive.
Chargers need to move with some tempo here, as there's just about 10 seconds left on the play clock. Kearney's in shotgun with 5 seconds on the play clock. He gets the snap off. It's a speed option to the right. He's going to keep it, and he's going to be tackled by Connor Tallis right around the sticks, but I believe short of a first down.
Chargers going to be third and short after the 10-yard run from Luke Kearney.
Third and one now, a big down here, as settling for a field goal will still make it a touchdown game. 7:45 left in the game. They can't settle. Luke Kearney on the QB sneak.
Kearney keeps over the left side with the quarterback.
He's gonna push forward for a first down at about the 9-10 yard line. And that's gonna set up about first and goal for the Chargers. 7:40 to go.
As the chains are moved. Chargers with not a lot of time on their hands. Both teams with two timeouts here to go in this fourth quarter. Very close game, 28-20. Still a one possession game. And Jackson, if the Chargers score here, you got to think that they'll be thinking going for two.
Absolutely. Kearney on the trickery to number four, Ellis. He's going to be met by Longbottom at the 1 yard line. Off of a touch pass from Kearney. And that's going to bring it to second and goal now for the Chargers on the 1 yard line.
Only 1 yard left to go. Chargers might be thinking QB sneak as they ran just two plays ago. Eagles defense really needs to make an adjustment here. Ben Longbottom will trot off the field as a substitution is made. Eagles really in need of a stop here to keep this game within striking distance.
6:45 as the Chargers will have an I formation. They'll hand it off to Hernandez, who barrels in for a touchdown. 26-28 on the score from the power handoff to the right side, as the Chargers are going to look to go for two here to tie the game.
Huge play coming up here for the Chargers. Could be the difference in tonight's matchup. If they convert this, they will tie the game. If not, the Eagles will hold on to a two-point lead. Eagles critically in need of a stop on this two-point conversion.
Each team's both still have two timeouts with 6.5 minutes to go in the fourth. Kearney lines up in shotgun with all the receivers bunched tight. Kearney drops back to pass. Emilio Bredgen, he's going to be sacked. And they're not going to convert. And that's going to lead the score 28-26. And the Eagles still lead by two.
No penalty flags on the field. And the Eagles will hold on to their two-point lead. 6.5 minutes left to go in the second half and in this matchup.
Eagles looking promising here, looking to convert on offense and expand on their two-point lead. A touchdown with an extra point here puts them at a nine-point lead, which makes it a two-possession game for the Eagles. We'll be right back after a short break.
Eagles lead the Chargers 28-26 after a failed two-point conversion by the Chargers. Eagles still have two timeouts, as do the Chargers, so can't go in full shutdown run the ball mode. Not enough, too much time left on the clock. They've got to get a couple first downs and will likely have to score on this drive to prevent the Chargers from coming back in this game. Jack Lowry on to kick it away, as he's going to squib that, he's gonna hit that one to the side. It's going to trickle out of bounds, and that's going to be a penalty, and that's going to bring the ball up to about the 35-yard line.
Great read there from Braylon Gardone. Did read this one correctly, as that ball bounced out of bounds compared to the one in the first quarter that simply died after hitting the ground. Eagles will set up shop at around the 35-yard line, looking to produce on offense here with 6.5 minutes left to go in the first half.
Dever in the offense, getting set up to get back on the field. As the Fort Bend coaches have a discussion with the officials. Appears to be some confusion between the coaches on the spot of the ball.
Test. Kick the bounds. They choose to re-kick. 5-yard penalty. Re-kick.
Eagles are going to take a re-kick instead of the ball in the 35. As opposed to that, they're trusting their returners here to get a good return.
Uncommon choice to accept this penalty. Typically, a kick out of bounds will be declined. Just take the ball from the 35. But the Eagles looking to their two return men, Braylon Gardone and Kobe Sellers, to get the job done here. With 6.5 minutes left to go in the game. Excuse me, that appears to be Brian Domino in the backfield with Braylon Gardone instead of Kobe Sellers.
Dallas Christian will be backed up on their kick another 5 yards, setting up an even better return potentially for Gardone or Brian Domino. Lowry set to kick it away for the second time. The kick is much deeper this time to Gardone as he fields it around the 10-yard line. Gardone's going to try and find a hole around the 30-yard line as a decision to not take the penalty and the ball at the 35 does not work out for the Eagles. They lose about 5 yards on that decision, and they get the ball at the 30-yard line.
Gardone running hard on that return will pick up about 25-30 yards, brings the ball to their own 30-yard line. We'll see what the offense can come out and do. The Eagles looking to capitalize on the lead that they have right now, looking to extend that to a point where the Chargers cannot come back in this game with only 6.5 minutes left.
6:30 to go. Eagles lead by two. Dever and the offense back out there looking to salt this game away. Dever's in shotgun. He fakes the handoff to Williams. It's going to be a dart to Domino across the middle. And he's going to be tripped up right around the 40-yard line, but a huge gain into Charger territory on the RPO.
And Domino clearly frustrated. He did not stay on his feet right there. He just got shoestring tackled by number 6 from the Chargers. That'll move the chains and much more, folks. That's going to be about a 40-yard gain for Brian Domino. Moves the ball to the Chargers side of the field.
6:05 remaining in the game. In the offense in the Charger territory. It's going to be a toss out to Ethan Williams. He's going to make a cut inside on the tackle. And he's going to get right back to the line of scrimmage for no gain.
Eagles looking to kill as much time of the clock as they can with very little time left here in this game. 5:45 on the clock. Clock will be running. Dever quickly lines his team back up. Eagles looking to score here.
5:30 left to go. Eagles will see if they try to drain more clock with each snap. Dever snaps it with 13 on the play clock. He's going to swing it out to Domino in a dangerous pass as he's going to get hit behind the line and lose about 4 yards. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 14 now.
3rd and long now for the Eagles, as that'll be a loss of about 4 yards on the bubble screen to Brian Domino. Eagles likely looking to throw downfield on this play.
We cross under 5 minutes left in the game as Eagles discuss what they're going to do here on third down. 12 seconds left on the play clock here as Dever lines up in shotgun with 3 receivers up top and Curry one-on-one down low. Dever gets the snap. He steps up in the pocket. He's going to run for it. And he's going to break a tackle and get tackled just short by about 2 yards of the first down. And that's going to bring up 4th down from the 32-yard line.
4th down and very short. And you got to think that the Eagles are looking to go for this. A field goal still puts you within touchdown range for the Chargers.
This would be a 49-yard kick. Not totally out of the range of Montoya, but he's already missed one tonight. But if the Eagles could get a first down here, they could start to burn through the Chargers' first timeouts, which would be a huge accomplishment. Max Granville now checks in to block. As the Eagles get ready.
3:55 and counting on the clock, folks. This is Eagles football. 28-26 is your score. 4th down and 2.
We'll see if the Eagles try and draw the Chargers off sides. As the Eagles line up in the pistol with 2 tight ends. As the Eagles will call a timeout. And they will not run a play here. We take a short break with them. 28-26, 3:35 left in the game. You're watching Eagles on the Air at FBCA TV. The Eagles keep their offense out there. They're looking to go for it on 4th and 2 after the timeout. The Eagles have 1 timeout remaining. The Chargers have just 2. Two tight ends lined up now on the field. 2 on the left side. The clock is adjusted to 3:45 now. As Ethan Williams is the running back in the backfield. Brian Domino's down low, and Braylon Gardoni is one-on-one up top. Dever's in shotgun. And there's a flag upon the play. And there's going to be a false start call on the Eagles.
We'll see the official discussion. And it appears the call.
Jalen Zuber was lined up in the neutral zone, I believe, and that's going to cost the Eagles 5 yards, and that's going to force head coach Jordan Black to bring out the punt team and not go for it. A huge break for the Chargers as they'll get the ball back.
Montoya looking to put this ball within the 5-yard line here for the Eagles, giving the Chargers bad field position to set up shop with about 3.5 minutes on the clock. Montoya on to punt here.
Chargers have two men back deep to receive this punt. 3:41 left on the clock. Plenty of time to drive down the field. That's going to be a very bad kick by Montoya. That's just going to sit around the 25-yard line. As that ball is going to be touched by the Chargers, and the Eagles are going to pick it up.
An incredible turn of events for the Eagles. We'll wait for the official call.
The officials are still discussing. As they call it, Fort Bend football. Oh my goodness.
And the Chargers with a horrible mistake. On their own 20-yard line, the Eagles are at 1st and 10 with 3.5 minutes to go.
So essentially a huge first down conversion will bring the offense back out on the field. And the Eagles are assuredly in field goal range now, which can make it a 5-point game if they can't convert a first down.
And this is never something you expect out of a football game, folks. But you know what they say, expect the unexpected. We'll see the official review here.
When a receiving team player touches the ball instantly becomes live, and anyone can touch it and grab the ball, and it becomes their ball. One of the Dallas Christian players made an attempt to get the ball, and then Sorrell Taylor jumped on the ball and picked it up, and it became Eagles ball right there. What a heads-up play by the Eagles to jump on that one. Dallas Christian looks too stunned to even make a substitution on the field right now and get the defense out there.
Coach Jordan Black looking clearly upset. We'll await an official call from the coaches. The officials will meet to discuss the call.
What's interesting right now is the Eagles have their punt team back in.
This appears to be the Eagle defense lining up with no Emmanuel Montoya on the field. We shall await the call from the officials. If this call does go in favor of the Eagles, they'll set up shop with offense in Charger territory. If not, the Chargers will have about 80 yards to go to the end zone.
Taking a long time to make this call, but Jordan Black seems to be showing clear confusion and frustration with the officials right now. I can't imagine they're going to call for a re-kick here.
So the bad kick by Emmanuel Montoya turns into a possible positive for the Eagles.
3:28 is still on the clock
here. Coach Mack now clapping. That might be a good sign for the Eagles.
Officials are now going to talk to the Dallas Christian head coach Wheeler. Punt team still seems it remains out in the field, and they are still pointing that it would be Eagles ball.
And while the referees and Coach Mike Wheeler discuss, we'll give a quick shout out to former broadcast member Cohen Carpenter and his family currently tuning in. Evan, a member of the broadcast team, and Coach Carp, the offensive coordinator for the Eagles. And as the decision has been made,
it appears that it will go in favor of the Chargers, and we will have a re-kick on the field.
Oh my goodness. Something I've never seen. I can't tell if they weren't able to make a call, so they're re-kicking if they... What appeared to be Eagle football on the 20-yard line now turned into a re-kick on 4th and 11. Manuel Montoya is back on the kick for the Eagles for his second time. Montoya sends this one high. It's going to roll down around the 10-yard line, and it's going to be picked up by Caleb Bratcher with 3:17 on the clock. And a crazy turn of events that nets the Chargers the ball.
Referees clearly could not make a decision there, so the decision was to have a re-kick. So it turned from Eagles setting up shop offense at the 20-yard line to the Chargers offense from the 20-yard line going the opposite direction, turned into a re-kick, and now the Chargers offense was set up from the 10-yard line.
Carney's in shotgun now for the Chargers. All he needs is to get into field goal range, and they can take the lead. 3:17 with two timeouts. Carney sends in motion. He looks downfield for a throw. He dodges one defender, and he's going deep. It's going to be picked off by Kobe Sellers at the 42-yard line, and that's going to be Eagle football.
That one will not be overturned. The Eagles will have the football in Charger territory. An incredible defensive play for number one, Kobe Sellers, to give the Eagles some momentum. 3 minutes on the clock. Eagles now with the ball in Charger territory. 28-26. Eagles still have the lead.
You know, sometimes they say ball don't lie. I wonder if that's one of those situations. Eagles have the ball now. 3:08 left on the clock on the 43-yard line.
Charger with two timeouts. We'll see if the Eagles opt to just chew as much clock as they can here.
Chargers are stacking the box here with five on the line and eight in the box. Dever with the high snap, hands it off. That's going to be a gain of about 2 yards for Ethan Williams. But that's going to begin to drain the clock.
As the play clock runs down, so does the game clock. We'll see what the Eagles look to do here. No timeout called from Dallas Christian.
Eagles will be able to snap this ball with around 2 minutes and 20 seconds left in the quarter. And there's 5 seconds on the play clock, and the Eagles are lined up in the pistol. Another high snap with a fake as Dever throws it to Donovan. He's going to catch it. He's going to get upfield for a first down and more. And he's going to get out of bounds around the 20-yard line on a huge pickup for the Eagles.
And you got to think that a touchdown here almost puts the game away, Jackson. That'll be a two-possession game. Chargers would have to score, kick an onside kick, get the ball back, and score again. So the Eagles could look to score here, put the game away right now, or simply run down the clock to the point where the Chargers cannot get the ball down the field in time.
2:14 on the clock here. Eagles can take this one inside of 2 minutes. The Chargers, keep in mind, still have two timeouts. Wonder when head coach Wheeler will start using them. Devers in shotgun with Ethan Williams as the back. Ethan Williams will tote the ball, and he's going to be tackled. And it's going to be a fumble. And it's going to be picked up by Dallas Christian as Brent around the 50-yard line in a crazy turn of events that has at midfield.
So it came from an interception from Kobe Sellers turned into a fumble from Ethan Williams. And the Chargers now have the ball at the 50-yard line.
Two left on the clock here. Eagles are up by two. The Chargers still have two timeouts. As the Chargers have the ball at midfield. What a turn of events in the last couple minutes.
This is football, folks. Chargers now have the ball at the 50-yard line. Jackson, I'm losing my voice up here. This has been a crazy game.
Two private school heavyweights battling it out. They're in separate divisions. They won't meet in the playoffs. This is for bragging rights. Kearney and shotgun. He hands it off to Hernandez. He's going to fake the handoff, and he's going to take a zone read to the right side and get up to the 30-yard line for a first down and more.
The chains will move, and the clock will stop as they do that. Ball now around the 30-yard line. The Chargers almost within field goal range.
And a field Kearney goal here. And a quarterback. Hernandez is going to hand it off, and he's going to be stopped right at the line. As there's a flag on the play.
That might be a personal foul against the Eagles on Connor Tallis. No! No, the flag will be waved off after some discussion. Tensions are high here, folks. 1:47 left on the clock. Eagles with a 2-point lead.
The clock continues to roll here. We are going to announce a player of the game in the conclusion of this contest. Kearney drops back, looking to throw. He's got a man wide open. It's going to be caught, and he's going to get out of bounds inside the 5-yard line with 1:28 on the clock.
Chargers making a move down the field. Ball will now be within the 5-yard line. As Kearney with an evasive move that tricked the Eagle defense.
Chargers have got to look to slow down the tempo now as they are almost assuredly going to score. As they're going to look to drain as much clock as possible before scoring.
Eagles can only hope for a Charger mistake or make a big play here on defense. Eagles in desperate need of a stop and a turnover.
The Chargers line up in I formation as they're going to do a toss sweep to the wide side. Hernandez is going to be blown up behind the line. And that's going to be a no gain as the clock will continue to run here. As the Chargers let the clock roll all the way. This will roll inside of around 40 seconds.
Chargers now with the ball on the Eagle 2-yard line. Getting to be under a minute left in this game. Chargers will take all the time they have. Eagles only with one timeout left. Chargers with two.
The Chargers line up in I formation. As they'll drain the clock as much as they can. Hand off to Hernandez is going to be in for a touchdown with 41 seconds to go in the game as the Chargers will take a 4-point lead.
Eagles in desperate need of a big play here. Once they get the ball back with one timeout and 40 seconds left, Brady Dever and the offense looking to make a statement here in Mesquite, Texas, and defeat the Dallas Christian Chargers.
What a drive by the Chargers to move the ball downfield, but have they left too much time on the clock for Brady Dever and the Eagles? That remains to be seen. As the Chargers line up for an extra point. As the Chargers will take a timeout, we'll take a timeout with them. 32-48 with 41 seconds to go because the Eagles on the air on FECA TV.
We take it.
Chargers now in to go for two here to make it a six-point game. Carney in a shotgun as the Eagles jump off sides. And there's a free play here for the Chargers as Hernandez is going to be tackled behind the line, but it won't matter.
Two-point conversion is no good, but then there's a penalty marker on the play.
They'll get a second try at this
on the defense.
As the Eagles jumped off sides. They'll now do this from the one-yard line.
I believe that will not change the coach's decision to go for two. Luke Carney and Hernandez in the backfield now as they go for attempt number two on the two-point conversion. Carney in shotgun as he checks back to the sideline for to change the play. 10 seconds on the play clock. Carney. And that's going to be blown up in the backfield on the shovel pass. And that's going to be no good in the two-point conversion. So the score will remain 32-28 yet again. But the Eagles in need of a touchdown to win this game. They've got 41 seconds and one timeout. It all comes down to Brady Dever and the offense.
Eagles really need a big return on the kickoff here. We'll see what Braylon Gardoni and Kobe Sellers can do. And after that, it'll be up to Brady Dever and his offense to get the Eagles a W tonight. We'll be right back after a short break.
Chargers get back on the field here, and as they get set to send this one away, Kobe Sellers and Braylon Gardoni are back deep to receive the kick. 41 seconds remains on the clock in the fourth quarter. We're in Dallas, Texas tonight. Both teams are 1-0 in the season, looking to stay undefeated. Lowry set to kick it away. That one's going to be kicked deep to about the 10-yard line. Gardoni's going to cover it. And he's going to make a move, and he's going to be tripped up while not even making it to the 25 as 3 seconds trail off the clock. As the Eagle offense has 38 seconds and one timeout to work with.
So Brady Dever and the rest of his offense look to make something happen here with 38 seconds left on the clock. One timeout for FBCA. The Eagles offense has done it before, and we'll see if they can do it again.
Dallas Christian only puts three down linemen as they'll likely drop. They drop seven into coverage. Dever looking downfield to Domino. Domino is going to be hit, and he's going to catch that one. And they're going to say that he caught that one out. He caught that inbounds and got out of bounds in time. It's 6 seconds trail off the clock. That's going to be second and five now. Dever in shotgun. He finds James Donovan. It's going to be incomplete out of hands. That one's going to be overthrown. For number six, James Donovan, that's going to bring up third down with 26 seconds left to go.
26 seconds left on the clock. Eagles have to have a big play here. Brady Dever will discuss with the coaches and then relay the info to his team. You got to think Dever's looking downfield to Domino or Gardoni on this play.
This is four down territory for the Eagles. They still have one timeout to play with. Dever drops back. Chargers rush three as he's chased from his blind side. As he whizzes it downfield to Domino, that's going to be caught at the 45-yard line. The clock will stop momentarily as there's 17 seconds left on the clock. Eagles have got to get up to the line, snap the ball, as the clock will start running once the ball is set. That timeout will be called by the Chargers.
Big play there from the Eagles to get the ball to the 45-yard line. Eagles need another big play, couple of big plays.
Ball on the 45. We'll take a timeout with them. 32-28, 17 seconds. This is Eagles on the air on FBCA TV. As the fourth and offense takes the field yet again, they need to go 55 yards here to score a touchdown. 17 seconds left in the game. As there's no timeouts with the Chargers and one for the Eagles, Eagles have got to move the ball downfield in a hurry. Dever fakes the throw. It's going to be a screen pass. As now he's going to get upfield, he's going to get a first down up to the 40-yard line. And that's going to be a 15-yard gain.
Number 7, Braylon Gardoni. That's good enough for an Eagle first down.
9 seconds left on the clock. Eagles spike it. And there remains 6 seconds now. As they'll have time for about one more shot at the end zone. They have time to go for a quick out and call a timeout. Or they can go straight to the end zone one more play because they have one timeout.
And if you remember, against the Woodlands Christian last year, into the first half, very similar situation. Braylon Gardoni throws the ball deep downfield for about 50 yards off the hands of the Woodlands Christian defense and into the arms of Braylon Gardoni for a touchdown. We'll see if they can work some similar magic this year.
Eagles are running out of time on the play clock. The play clock dwindles down to 5, 4, 3, 2. Play clock gets reset to 25. Dever in shotgun. As he goes for a quick out, that's going to be incomplete with 2 seconds left on the clock. Dallas Christian thought the game had ended. But there's still two seconds left on the clock here as Eagles will have one more shot at the end zone.
Timeout will be taken by the Eagles to discuss the play. We'll be right back after a short timeout.
Timeout, Eagles.
Seconds left on the clock. No timeouts left. The Eagles in need of a touchdown. Down by 4. This, folks, is the last play of the game. The Chargers are in prevent defense as they'll only rush three and drop everybody else back. Dever strolls up in the pocket. He's going to chunk it downfield. And that one's going to be overthrown. And that's going to be the ball game. The Chargers take down the Eagles 32-28 on their home field. What an amazing game. And what amazing play by both teams.
Not the way the Eagles wanted to end tonight. Obviously, wanted to come out of Mesquite with a victory, but an amazing performance from the Eagles. Also a great performance from Dallas Christian, the Chargers. Great game to them. Quick thank you to Dallas Christian for hosting us today, for hooking us up with some gear for broadcast, for giving us such a nice environment to play football in. Jackson, before we close tonight, it's time to pick a player of the game.
I'm going to have to give player of the game to Max Granville with a couple of nice sacks and a fumble recovery. He really helped spark the Eagles defense as they just came up short in this game. What a performance. But that'll do it for us, folks. We're signing off. I'm Jackson Champion. This is Derek Jordan. We'll see you next week as the Eagles take on St. John's at home. Make sure to tune into the broadcast. Thank you for watching Eagles on the Air and FBCA TV. Good night.